Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Glen Abbey Golf Club. Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue. Thank you for those joining us on Facebook Live and via Twitter. Welcome to Media Day for the RBC Canadian Open. We have a fabulous day planned. We want to thank everyone who came out and enjoyed the morning golf. And for those that are planning on going out this afternoon, you've got a wonderful day. Golf course is in fabulous condition. Before we get started with our program, I just want to introduce a number of special people. Leslie Dunning, President of Golf Canada. Leslie, thank you for joining us from Calgary. We also have a number of board members, Tom Sears, Liz Hoffman, thank you for joining us as well. Kevin Thistle, CEO of the PGA of Canada. As well as new President of the PGA of Canada, Mark Patterson. Mark, thanks for joining us. Mike Kelly, Executive Director of Golf Ontario. Where's Mike? I know he was coming. Playing 18. Jim Clark, Chair of the RBC Canadian Open. Where's Jim? There he is. Super volunteer right there. I believe Ray saw he was going to join us, Principal with ClubLink, and will be joining us. Also very pleased to be joined by Chris Hamill, President of the Hamilton Golf and Country Club, host of the 2019 and 2023 RBC Canadian Open, as well as Peter Holt, Chief Operating Officer. Peter, thank you for joining us. Before I call up our first speaker, I'd like to direct your attention to the screen for a quick video. I'd like to call up our first speaker, Executive Vice President, Chief Marketing Officer with RBC. Please welcome Mary DePauli.
Thank you, Dan, and good morning, everyone. Thanks for being here. Today we have some very exciting news to share with all of you. It is a great day for golf in Canada, and it's a new chapter and a new era for the RBC Canadian Open. Now, moments like this would not be possible unless it were for two things: strong partnerships and a shared vision. And so to that end, I would like to call upon two key partners to join me here on stage. Andy Pasder, who is Chief Tournaments and Competitions Officer for the PGA Tour. And Andy joins us from Ponte Vedra, Florida. He came to Canada to get some real heat, of course. And Lawrence Applebaum, who's the Chief Executive Officer for Golf Canada. Now, later in the program, we'll be joined by Adam Hadwin, who is PGA Tour player, of course, Team RBC Ambassador, and he'll be joining us by Skype. I'd like to thank the PGA Tour, Andy, and also Commissioner Jay Monahan in particular and their team. The Tour continues to be an exceptional partner to RBC, and they are fully aligned with our vision of investing in golf in Canada. And Andy deserves much credit. He is one of the reasons why we are here today to share some great news with you. He and his team have worked tirelessly to get us to this point. I'd also like to thank Lawrence and his team at Golf Canada. They have also been exceptional partners, and year after year continue to deliver an outstanding RBC Canadian Open. So thank you, Lawrence, to you, to Bill Paul, and to your team for everything that you do. I'd also like to acknowledge the extraordinary effort of the team at RBC who supports our global golf portfolio. It is led by Matt McGlynn, includes Shannon Cole, Mark Soder, Gemma Fox, and our PR and communications team who are supporting us here today. It also includes the team at Wasserman under the leadership of Steve Marshman. This is a group of individuals who cares about golf and who cares about bringing the best to the tournaments that we have, both the RBC Canadian Open here in Canada, but also the RBC Heritage Tournament that is played every April in beautiful South Carolina. So thank you to this team. Now, we're very proud of the fact that in Canada, the RBC Canadian Open is the only stop for the tournament on the schedule here in Canada. And it remains, as you know, one of the most historic tournaments in the world. And this tournament is important to us. It's important to all of us. It's important to the sport of golf. It is important to enticing and attracting the fans of the future. And as such, it deserves every advantage. And so today we have an important announcement to make. We are thrilled, absolutely thrilled, to officially announce that starting in 2019, the RBC Canadian Open will have a new premier spot in June on the PGA Tour's schedule. Now we have more news to share as well, because in addition to this tremendous date, we also have a significantly larger purse. The purse will be moving from $6.4 million US this year to $7.6 million US in 2019, a lift of $1.2 million. And we believe, and we're quite confident of the fact, that the combination of a June date and a more competitive purse will lead to an elevated tournament for a number of reasons. We are now an early stop in the tournament's schedule when competition is running high. We are now positioned as part of a core cluster of high caliber events. We expect to see more European golfers playing in North America in the run-up to the US Open. We now have the opportunity to enhance player recruiting efforts to strengthen the field for this event, as the logistics to come to the RBC Canadian Open became that much simpler. And a strong field, as you all know, is critical to driving fan engagement and also TV viewership. And our own Team RBC is quite helpful in that regard. They're not just outstanding golfers, including the world number one player, but they are also proud ambassadors of the RBC brand and will do a lot to entice their peers to attend our tournament in future. And finally, RBC is committed as a company to elevating the fan experience for golf by bringing the best of all of our sponsorship platforms to bear. For example, we have an excellent partnership with Live Nation, and reaching Canadians through music is a critical part of our sponsorship efforts. A few moments before this press conference began, we announced that this year we are hosting a concert on the Sunday of the RBC Canadian Open, featuring multi-platinum singer-songwriter Demi Lovato and Grammy Award winner Jason Mraz, with proceeds from ticket sales going to Kids Help Phone. We will be incorporating this concert's activation throughout the entire week of the RBC Canadian Open, and we believe that things like concert activation, unique fan experiences, will just continue to elevate the overall fan experience at our tournament. And it's important to note this, because music captures the attention of young and old, and when tied to golf, it serves as an important entry point for new generations of fans. It is also yet another feature to attract players and their families to our tournament. So, I want to thank all of you for attending today and for your support. As I mentioned at the start, this tournament deserves every advantage, and we now have momentum, and we now have a clear shot to make this one of the most outstanding tournaments on the PGA Tour schedule. June 3rd through 9th, 2019 marks the start of a very new and important era for us, and I am very pleased and excited about what the future holds for us. And so with that, I will turn things over to Andy.
Thank you, Mary. It's my privilege to represent the PGA Tour, Commissioner Jay Monahan and all the great staff members that I have the honor of working with. Today is a very significant day for the PGA Tour. Our partnership with RBC extends back to 2008. My friendship with Mary now dates back 3 years. It's been a wonderful opportunity for me to learn about RBC, learn what they stand for, and again, today is just a fantastic day. So we're on the verge of announcing in a week's time the most significant schedule change on the PGA Tour in a dozen years since the advent of the FedEx Cup. And it presented a fabulous opportunity for us to take a step back and evaluate our schedule. And we saw an opportunity to address a point of conversation with Mary and her team members, going back to Gordon Nixon and Dave McKay has been a great supporter as well, to position the RBC Canadian Open in a new date. And I want to share with you an anecdote, a story, if you will, just bear with me here. And it dates back to June 21st, last summer. That was the day that Mary and Lawrence sat in my office and we spoke about the future of the RBC Canadian Open. Commissioner Jay Monahan wasn't even through his first 6 months as our new commissioner. He joined our meeting. And it was at that moment when Mary looked across the table at the commissioner and said, "Jay, sitting here today, knowing what you know, what does it look like? What is the chance that we will have an opportunity to have a new date?" And Jay paused, which he rarely does. I gulped. And Jay said, "I think it's probable." And we were exchanging some text messages on June 21st. I was reminding Mary of that very moment. And I look back with great inspiration for Jay's vision. It's not something that happened very easily. Putting together the PGA Tour schedule is very complicated. But when you have an amazing partner like we do with RBC, who sponsors not just this great event, but also our tournament on Hilton Head Island, the RBC Heritage, and a great partner in Lawrence and Golf Canada, it makes the decision much, much easier. So you think about the RBC Canadian Open, Mary alluded to it earlier, and it's great, great history. The fourth oldest tournament on our schedule. 109th playing, I believe, this year, Lawrence. 21 World Golf Hall of Fame members have won this tournament, and that's a stunning number. I'll go ahead and put Tiger and Jim Furyk. Let's make it 23 Hall of Famers have won this tournament. Jason Day's on track, maybe. Maybe he'll make it number 24. So the history is amazing. Our objective when we put our schedule together is to put great tournaments in great dates. And we think we've done that with the RBC Canadian Open. I'm also excited for the golf fans in Canada. I had the great privilege of being at the President's Cup in 2007. And the cheers and the roars just will never leave me. Mike Weir taking down Tiger Woods on Sunday in singles. You go back to 2004, right here, Mike in a playoff with Vijay Singh trying to be the first Canadian since 1954, Pat Fletcher. Those roars were incredible. The history of golf in Canada is robust. We're super excited to deliver this great opportunity for golf fans. As Mary said, it places the event on the front end of our summer schedule. It gives players a great opportunity to gain momentum into the summer months. I note that the last three U.S. Open winners all played the week prior, and we hope that trend continues for many years going forward. We have presented an opportunity to Lawrence and his team to continue to grow this event. Grow the economic impact in the area, grow its impact on charity, deliver a world-class tournament to the golf fans of Canada. And that's something that we are incredibly, incredibly excited. So it's my pleasure to represent the PGA Tour. This is, as Mary said, a historic day. Lawrence will touch on a little bit more of that in a moment. I thank everyone in the room for your great support, from sponsors to fans to the media that covers the event annually. RBC is a global brand. The PGA Tour is a global organization. We have 85 players from 23 different countries. Our telecasts are beamed across 220 countries and territories. And we've got a tremendous opportunity to show the world what the RBC Canadian Open is all about. So with that, I'd like to call up Lawrence Applebaum, CEO of Golf Canada. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Andy. And what an opening, Mary. Today is a historic day for golf in Canada. It's about momentum and looking ahead to this exciting new journey and chapter for the RBC Canadian Open. Aujourd'hui est une journée historique pour le golf canadien. Nous débutons un nouveau chapitre excitant pour le Omnium Canadien RBC. Je félicite Mary and nos fantastic partners d'RBC. I am legitimately proud to be standing here with Mary and her entire team from RBC. They have made an incredible difference in this sport in this country. And it is due to that commitment to excellence that we have this new chapter to write. RBC is the most engaged and committed partner in Canadian golf. They support golf not only at the upper echelons, but in our development program with Team Canada, in our Golf Canada Foundation, and even with our wonderful partners at the PGA of Canada with the RBC PGA Scramble. I really want to deeply thank Mary and Dave Mackay for this trust that you've put in us to continue to operate this event and make you proud. I also deeply want to thank Andy Pasder, who on the most holy of holy days before July 1st in the US, July 4th, comes up to Canada. He leaves 100 degree heat in Ponte Vedra and he comes to 95 degree heat in Oakville. And on behalf of Jay Monahan, spreads his support from the PGA Tour. There's a great story going on at the PGA Tour and many of the media here have begun writing that story, but it is the most impressive tour on the planet. Jay is ushering a new era for golf, an era of inclusion, an era of opportunity and excitement. Many of you saw this dynamite rights deal that was done with Discovery. And this change in schedule is so impactful for us in Canada. And coming next week, the rest of the schedule will be announced. It's very exciting. I want to publicly and very personally, on behalf of Golf Canada, thank the PGA Tour for their incredible support from Jay, Andy, the entire management team who has invested in their time, money, and energy into this sport and supporting us at Golf Canada for putting on a great PGA Tour event. I also want to thank our many partners who came out here today and see so many friendly faces in every aspect of our business who've joined us. BMW, Steam Whistle, Acushnet, ClubLink, so many just to name a few, and many partners who've joined us for the day help us celebrate this new chapter. A move to this June date is so many things for us. It helps our partners in their timing for activation, investment, and hosting. It helps us as an organization with hosting, sales, corporate hospitality, with volunteers, one of the lifebloods of any organization. Our volunteers are a critical aspect, and this date will help us with our volunteers. With our players, and Mary alluded to some major componentry, we have this dynamic new purse, and $7.6 million US for us here in this room know it's about $10 million Canadian. This event will provide a great lead up the week before the US Open, a great opportunity for players for the lead in, to provide a great experience as we've always had, to provide great logistics, great support, great communication, and a great opportunity for this entirely important part of the schedule. But most importantly, it's about fans. It's the heart of the golf season. This avoids some of the opportunities that people have in our shortened summer for holidays, and June date allows it for people to really experience the wonderful temperature and environment we have in the middle of June. And as an organization for Golf Canada, We host two major events. We host the RBC Canadian Open and our CP Women's Open. And providing a bit of a gap between the August date of the CP Women's Open allows us to really, really put our energy and time into this June date. This also offers an opportunity for synergies with two of our great global partners. Both the USGA and the RNA are fundamental partners of Golf Canada as the governing body of this country, and we've had wonderful dialogues with both parties and continue to work with them for future opportunities. I'd like to talk a little bit about 2018, if I could. We're now 20 days from the 109th playing of the Open here at Glen Abbey. And for those of you who got a chance to taste it this morning, and will have a chance later this afternoon to play it this afternoon, it's in exquisite shape. The team here at Glen Abbey have done a wonderful job of getting it championship ready. We have arguably the greatest field we've ever had for the RBC Canadian Open in 2018. Leading the way is Dustin Johnson, the world number one ranked player, coming off a great run through the spring with his win in Memphis and his third place at the US Open. We have two-time US Open champion, Brooks Koepka, coming back. We have Bubba Watson, a three-time winner this year on the PGA Tour and arguably one of the hottest players on the planet. We have a whole set of combatants from the US Open, four out of the top five players, including Tommy Fleetwood and Tony Finau, who cut his teeth right here on the PGA Tour of Canada with the Mackenzie Tour. We also have Ryder Cup star and perennial fan favorite Ian Poulter joining us. This is also an incredible field when it comes to Canadian golfers and the deepest talent we've ever had in Canada playing on the PGA Tour. It starts with world number 48 Adam Hadwin and continues on with Nick Taylor, Mackenzie Hughes, Corey Connors, David Hearn, Ben Silverman, and of course, a golfer that I'm thrilled to welcome back in Mike Weir. Our Open will be a week-long celebration of golf in Canada, starting with our National Skills Challenge, our FutureLinks National Skills Challenge on Saturday. We have Hall of Fame Day on Tuesday, celebrating our many Hall of Fame members and our two new inductees. Canadian Hall of Fame will induct LPGA Tour winner and broadcaster Gail Graham, as well as the legendary golf architect A.V. McCann. Friday will be our legendary Red and White Day, while all players, spectators, fans will be encouraged to wear their colors and celebrating the field. Today is a landmark day for the RBC Canadian Open. It's also a day to celebrate and thank our incredible partners at RBC for their unbelievable commitment to this event and to the sport and golf in this country. I now have the honor, and technology, God willing, to welcome one of our great friends and tour players, Adam Hadwin.
This is kind of weird. I'm staring at my face at the screen right now, so bear with me if I kind of look off or anything, but this is an extremely exciting day for golf in Canada. I can't really add much to what Andy, Lawrence, and Mary have already said, but this is an incredible opportunity for the RBC Canadian Open to regain the stature that it has had on the PGA Tour for a number of years. I have been a proud member of RBC, Team RBC, for a number of years. Thank you there. Now I'm not looking at myself. I've been a proud member of Team RBC for a number of years, and what they have done for golf, not only for Canada, but for golf on the global stage is incredible. They have adopted a number of us to the team. They have taken on two tournaments, and they continue to make both tournaments some of the best that we play on the PGA Tour. This new date for the Canadian Open is incredible. This will elevate this tournament, like I said before, back to the stature that it has had. It will make it a lot easier to attract all the great players that I know want to come up and play, but maybe just haven't been able to fit in their schedule yet before. It gives us an opportunity to show off the area, maybe in a different climate as well. I know I just came back from the Northeast and it was extremely hot there. So June date will help with that as well. It's an exciting time for golf in Canada. And sorry I can't be there with you personally. I wanted to be, but this is the next best thing I could do. And I'm excited to share this news with all of you.
If you've ever done FaceTime or Skype, congratulations, Adam, on really not looking down. That is probably the hardest thing. Wonderful announcement. We are going to open it up for Q&A from our floor. We have microphones. Where's our microphones? One over here and one on that side. Please raise your hand and let us know who you're with and who your question is directed to. So we'll open up the Q&A. Hunter?
Question for all three of you. Lawrence, you call this a landmark day. Mary and I touched on this prior to proceedings this morning, but how much work has this last 2.5 years gone into, or how much effort and time has been put into this to get to where we are with this announcement today?
You can.
Okay. Hey, Rick. So I would say that the team began working on this at the time of renewal, which was just over 2 years ago. And Andy and Jay were quite receptive to the fact that in renewing for a sport that has great alignment to our values and also our business objectives at RBC, there were certain considerations that we were hoping to achieve, in that it had been about a decade at that time when we saw ourselves following a major and preceding a WGC event. So it was very important to us to see a change in schedule. And I would say that Andy and Jay were quite receptive to looking at it when the schedule opened up. At that point, we weren't clear as to when that would be or how it would transpire, but we trusted them. And we trusted that they would hear one of their tournaments, hear one of their major sponsors who has two tournaments and supports Team RBC, but also supports the community. And it just makes good economic sense for golf in Canada. And so we presented our vision. Earlier, Andy talked about the fact that Lawrence and I visited the tour in Florida. And we talked about the vision that we had around what a tournament could be and some of the elements that we would need to get to what that vision ultimately was. So I would say 2.5 years ago it began. The last year in earnest has been quite active for all of us and for our teams. But we're very happy with the outcome.
This just isn't about Lawrence and Mary. There is a lot of work that you and Jay have to put into this as well.
So, Rick, I would add a couple things. I would say that the process started much earlier than 2.5 years ago. So the FedEx Cup started in 2007. We look at it every single year. How do we make our season-long competition better? And we realized many years ago that competing in America against college football and the NFL was going to be challenging. And we knew for the FedEx Cup to continue to grow in stature, we needed to conclude our playoffs prior to football, which frankly dominates the sports landscape starting in September. And that was the beginning. So to make all this happen, we had conversations with the PGA of America about moving their major championship from August into May. The PGA Tour moved its flagship event, the Players' Championship, from May to March, and that started the dominoes falling. So during those conversations, decisions, meetings, et cetera, we were in discussions with Mary and her team and Golf Canada on a long-term extension. They continue to voice a desire to have an opportunity to improve the event, improve the date. And to come to today and realize our dream and to make it happen is something we're extremely proud about. There were many points along the way where, again, our schedule, I can't overstate how complicated it is to put together, but we knew that RBC, and again, their support of golf, not just in Canada, but of the professional sport of golf, is unparalleled. And to have a great partner like that certainly makes the decision-making process a lot simpler, a lot easier, a lot smoother. And we have a great champion in RBC. Their support, again, is unparalleled. So we're thrilled to be part of the announcement today. You know, we will announce our full schedule on July 10th, but as a gesture to Mary and her team and Lawrence as to what this means to the PGA Tour, we did make a decision to announce today's date, a luxury we did not afford some other sponsors. I feel my phone vibrating in my pocket.
Andy's staying in Canada.
And I'm resisting the urge to look at it right now. Hopefully my battery will run out. So anyways, great day indeed.
Rick Drennan?
Rick Drennan from Pro Shop Magazine. The symmetry of a U.S. and a Canadian Open in the same year is kind of cool. Any chance for like a North American champion? Is there lots of marketing opportunities available to the PGA Tour because of that?
Excellent question. So having two historic national opens back-to-back, the possibilities are endless. I know Lawrence has had a number of conversations with the USGA about some closer alignment between the two organizations and the two opens. The Triple Crown trophy, Lawrence, I think exists somewhere. Yeah. Might be interesting to resurrect that. It would be fun to talk about somebody winning the RBC Canadian Open and the U.S. Open and trying to complete the Triple Crown, pardon me, at the Open Championship. So the possibilities are endless. We're excited.
Question? John.
Hi, John Chidley Hill from the Canadian Press. This question is for Lawrence. How important is it for the growth of the sport of golf in Canada to have the Canadian Open in a premier spot in the PGA Tour season?
Yeah. You know, the first thing is for our organization as the governing body of golf in this country, the professional game is at the top of the pyramid, and it drives substantial interest, it drives substantial economic impact to our entire organization, and we put a ton of energy and time and resources behind it. And to be able to put on this platform and this stage where we can host our great Canadians, our great world players in these iconic locations is one of our key strategies and one of our key objectives for our organization. And the chance to get the world's eyes, the more than close to 1 billion eyes around the world into Canada for this week is such an incredible opportunity for us, and that's what we're really thrilled about.
Next question.
Sure. Is that one for me?
Yeah.
So. Great. Well, first, I know he snuck in just as we got started. I wanted to welcome Mr. Ray Sahi to the front row. Ray, take a stand and just thank you for joining us. We've had an incredible partnership with ClubLink, with Ray, with John Finlayson, the CEO, and Tim Green, who's here today. And we've been really proud about our association. The 30th playing will be this year. We're very excited. We also have here in the front row the executive team and the board, the president from Hamilton Golf and Country Club, which is, from the player feedback, has been so well received. It's an exquisite track. It's an incredible canvas to put on the event, and we're so thrilled to, in 2019, with our date change, to begin this new chapter in Hamilton. As far as 2020 and 2021, we've had really developed discussions with a number of phenomenal golf courses, epic tracks, places that people want to play, places that players want to get to. And hopefully within the very short term, we'll have some announcements in that regard.
For anyone who's interested, I believe we also have Adam Hadwin still on the line. If anybody has any questions for Adam, please raise your hand. Or for any of our guests, show of hands. Sorry, I can barely see because of the lights. Any more questions? Okay. Well, thank you very much, everybody. Wonderful announcement, Mary and RBC and Andy. Thank you very much for joining us. Fabulous afternoon for those of us who are playing golf. Lunch, we do have lunch set up for those that are joining. Please help yourself. What we're going to do is we're going to strike the table. We're going to set up for a couple of quick photo opportunities. We're also going to use the full podium with backdrops for any of our scrums and one-on-ones. Thank you very much, everybody, for joining us. Exciting new chapter for the RBC Canadian Open. Please join us July 23rd to 29th, right back here at Glen Abbey. It's going to be another fabulous event. And thank you for joining us.